Happy Thursday, everyone. I'm here with Amanda. I'm Sam. We're with the Deep Trekker team here in the Deep Trekker shop, and we want to give you an idea about what it's like to get your very own Deep Trekker DTG2 ROV and what it looks like in the box and how to get yourself up and running as quickly as possible. So Amanda, if we could just help me here unlatch the box. Once you open the box, you'll see that you've got your ROV upside down. This one is the DTG2 worker model, so it's got the gripper arm installed. The gripper arm is at the top. Normally, when it's in the water, that's at the bottom. All Deep Trekkers are packed upside down with the frame at the back. This helps hold it in place and keep the frame from swinging when it's in transit. So you'll find the box. You've got your controller, which is not yet attached to the reel. And you've got your ROV. Amanda, maybe you can help me take it out. So the ROV we've got, we'll flip upside down. Take the case. And then inside the case, you've got your reel. So on the reel is attached the other end of the black cord where your controller attaches. And you simply put those together. Screw in the screw, and you're good to go there. I'll put that back in the box. Now, Amanda, can you give us a demonstration on how the shipping screws are installed?
Yeah, so when you first get it, if you put it in the water, it's gonna sit facing up, and you're gonna wonder why isn't it working. That's because there's shipping screws in it. So, if you turn it around, take a flathead screwdriver, and just back out the two screws that are in the middle there, until your pendulum swings inside.
Do those come all the way out, Amanda?
Nope, they just back against the bracket here. And then once it's swinging all the way, you know you're ready to go.
And there's always two.
There's always two.
And what are they used for?
It's just whenever UPS rolls them around and likes to beat them up on the way to your adventure, that if the pendulum doesn't swing and damage the insides of the Deep Trekker.
Awesome. Now, do I need to put these shipping screws back in every time I use the ROV?
No, not unless you're going on a flight or going in some sort of rugged terrain where the pendulum would swing around a lot.
Awesome. So, you've got the shipping screws out, we've got the controller attached, and now what we simply need to do is turn it on. You'll see the camera come up, picture show up on the screen, and you're ready to put it in the water.